Hello, this is 13 Heathen speaking. I hope everyone's doing well. Sorry, I'm just having my second cup of coffee now. I'm not really awake. I got a call early hours in the morning through Skype from a friend of mine that I hadn't heard from a little bit of a while. He's been busy, but apparently he got in a discussion with somebody and trusted me to help with a little bit of refutation, which I definitely appreciated. Now, this particular stuff had to do with astronomy, and I recommended that he go and send a note to the bad astronomer, Phil Platt, I believe his name is. Decent guy, I'm subscribed to him, and usually if there's something really neat or interesting going on in the universe, I usually hear something from him. And I might have heard something about this particular instance a while back, but I don't remember hearing much of anything about it from that source, so I don't really know. Thing is, I'm not a science guy. I'm just some schmuck with a Google account. You know, I can go out there, I can do my little search and this kind of stuff, and most things are frighteningly easy to refute. But I kind of am getting ahead of myself here. You see, this friend called me because he was frustrated because he'd gotten in a conversation with a family member who, oh boy, what's the best way to put this? Apparently, it's that time of year again, and the world is ending. This happens at least, it seems, I don't know, lately it seems like it's two or three times a year that the world ends. Of course, the world's still here long after it ends, and nothing significant happens. But that doesn't stop them from running around insisting that, for whatever reasons, the world is ending. Oh, or that the aliens are coming, or that the rapture is here, or whatever it happens to be this week. So, in this case, he was talking about a comet called ison. So, let's see now. This is the comet ison. This is the trajectory. I managed to find this fairly easy, and incidentally, you may note here. Let's see now, there it is. This is where it is now, October 7th. Ooh, looks so close to Mars, doesn't it? Ooh, scary. Actually, that's not the closest part of the flyby, but at this point, it is only 15 million miles, that'd be 24 million kilometers, away from Mars. And it's on a trajectory to the Sun. Now, as you'll see here from this graph here, it's going to do a neat little, almost, you know, Captain Kirk-style slingshot around the Sun thing there. Unfortunately, I don't think there'll be any time travel involved, thank you very much. But that'd be cool. Now, oh great, of course, now that I'm making a video, the dog finally wants back in. Now, this is the reality of the case. Now, if you look here, there is one point in which it looks like it's going to get awfully close to Earth. Now, let's hit play here. Here it comes, pause. Whoop, didn't pause. There we go. Well, regardless, that's, see where it is? See where Earth is? Nowhere nearby. Yes, the line goes awfully close. Look at that, it goes right across that orbit of the Earth. Long before the Earth's anywhere near it. And if I can back this up here a little bit. Let's figure this out. There we go. Now, at the point at which it starts crossing over the plane where the Earth is 116 million miles away at that point. So I don't think that's too much of a threat. And it goes down by where the Sun is, and whoop, there we go. Now, I don't think the actual direction of the tail is going to reverse. That'd be kind of interesting if it did. But that's just the way that the program works, I believe, here. But as you see, at this point, it is not... Oh, wait, no, we're going to argue that it's going to come back towards the Earth. Well, hang on, let's look at the side view here. So how close is this sucker going to get to Earth? Oh, there we go. Now that it's crossing the plane of the Earth, it's, let's see now, 74 million miles away. Now, there is a point in its orbit that is technically, or rather, yeah, in its trajectory, that is technically a little bit closer. There's a point that it gets to be all close to 40 million miles away. Yeah, not too big a thing. Well, why am I bothering to talk about this? Why am I bothering to make a big deal out of it? Well, let's go to YouTube. Let's see now. Oh, no. Comet ison. Mega comet earthquake to tsunami predicted for October 13th. Yeah. Famor Fezzel, biblical signs pertaining to the comet. Debris hitting Earth now! NASA's preparing! Oh, apparently NASA's shut down their website, not simply because of the government shutdown. No, it's because they don't want you to know the truth. Ooh. Oh, good grief. Government shutdown preparations, thing that purchased YouTube? What? Ugh. It's actually Planet X Nibiru! We're apparently also going to get stuck in the corona, which, as you see, is so close to Earth when it's, you know, 51 million miles away at that point. Huge asteroid captured in the comet's corona, and that asteroid's going to be flung at us at some... Yeah, whatever. Oh, boy. Nah. Oh, there's a UFO riding in the tail, of course. There we go. UFO in the tail. Mm-hmm. Always have to have that UFO crap. It may not really be a comet. Oh, what is this? Yeah, star blazers, and it's actually that giant thing from Star Blazers that it slows down, and it's not really a comet. It's a giant ship carved out of... Oh, come on, guys. Give me a break. Oh, boy. It's insane. I'm waiting for the one claiming that there's a conspiracy theory and that the U.S. or some other nation made the comet and is flinging it at ourselves. Is it really a comet? Where is it right now? It's coming to get us! Ah! Oh, good grief, people. Come on, I get tired of this. Okay, Comet Ison is bringing spiritual darkness. Oh, boy. Yeah. Well, this October 1st deadline here has already gone past, apparently. I'm really tired of this. Really, really tired. So, yeah, apparently, here we go. Let's rewind this to the beginning, because this article's been going on for a little bit of a while. Let's show this comet come by and destroy all life on Earth! Like in every other frickin' prediction. Oh, well, there you go. Boy, look at that. That's clearly going to destroy all life on Earth. Yep. Other claims that I've heard are pertaining to EMP pulses that are going to take out everything and this kind of crap. It's kind of a conglomeration of varied stories. There was an article a little while ago claiming that the Anons were going to take out the U.S. power grid, and I'm thinking, why the hell would the Anons do that? I mean, they're obnoxious, they're trollish, but, well, huh? But even then, the articles are saying they might have this capability within the next 4 years, or 2 years, or 3 years, whichever, but we're talking years away. But, I mean, all this end-of-the-world stuff I get so tired of, because it seems like the world is ending at least once a month, and of course it's still here. Oh, I get really tired of these people making money off of, in most of these cases, making money off of sitting there and trying to get people all freaked out and paranoid. I mean, come on, people, what the hell's the matter with you? It's a comet. They go by all the fucking time. And this one's not even hitting the sun, of course. They're insisting it's going to hit the sun, and it's going to make this massive solar flare come and destroy the entire fucking Earth. And, oh, come on, people. Just stop this shit. Come on. Google it, for Christ's sakes. Do something. Don't just sit there going around whipping everyone up into a frenzy, claiming that the government is trying to suppress the truth when... Huh? Come on. Ugh, fuck off. Have a good day. 13 Heathens out.